Hello everyone. Most of the vocal learners and instrument learners are having a great confusion, that is how to differentiate between ni1 ni2 or ga1 ga2 by listening to it, how to write the notation, how to identify a swarasthana or how to identify which swaram it is. So these all doubts will be clarified with this video. I am considering three ragas: Mayamalavagavala, Shankarabharanam and Shanmukapriya. So with these three ragas, I will be demonstrating on Veena and I will be singing also. So with this, you will be knowing the nature of each and every swarasthanam. So basically, I will be telling about all the dwadasa swarasthanas, that is Shadjam, Shuddha Rishabham, Chatushruti Rishabham, Sadharana Gandharam, Antara Gandharam, Shuddha Madhyamam, Prati Madhyamam, Panchamam, Shuddha Daivatam, Chatushruti Daivatam, Kaisiki Nishadam and Kakali Nishadam. These are the dwadasa swarasthanas. You need to know the nature and the mood of each and every swarasthana. It is sung actively or it is sung dull. So like this, you need to know the mood of each and every swarasthana. Then it is very easy to identify each and every swarasthana. With that, you can identify a ragam. If you identify a ragam, you can compose any composition in that ragam. Like for example, a film song or a poem or a sloka, you can compose in that ragam. So to know all those, you need to know this dwadasa swarasthanas perfectly. So we all know about Mayamalavagola swarasthanas, that is Shadjam, Shuddha Rishabham, Antara Gandharam, Shuddha Madhyamam, Panchamam, Shuddha Daivatam and Kakali Nishadam. Sa is common. Listen to this sound carefully. Re 1, Shuddha Rishabham. So basically that re is very dull. So if somebody is singing a Rishabham very dull, that is nothing but the Shuddha Rishabham. Remember this point, okay? If you give gamakam also, that dullness will be dullness only. So if you give gamakam to re also, that is same. It is dull only. So now you got how re 1 is sung. Now let us go to Ga 2, that is Antara Gandharam, which is coming in Mayamalavagola. Ga. You need to remember, okay, this Ga I have heard it in Mayamalavagola. So this is Antara Gandharam. If you be perfect with these three ragas, the Arohanam and Avarohanam, you can identify any swarasthana. In Dwadasa swarasthanas, I am not telling about Shodasa swarasthanas, okay? Is Antara Gandharam. I am opening and singing that ga. Sa ga. Boldly, openly I am singing. That is Antara Gandharam. Okay, Antara Gandharam is coming in Mayamalavagola. So if this Antara Gandharam is sung in any other ragam, for example Kapi or Ananda Bhairavi, yes, this is Antara Gandharam. I have heard it in Mayamalavagola. You can differentiate easily. Let us go to Shuddha Madhyamam. Ma. Ma also, I am opening and I am singing boldly. It is a straight line. Ma is Ma 1. Pa. Da. I haven't opened my mouth much. Da. Same like Re. So this is Shuddha Daivatam. Ni. It is almost touching the Tarasthai Shadjam. So if the knee which is equivalent to Tarasthai Shadjam, that is Kakali Nishadam. This is easy to remember. Ni sa. Now you got to know the swarasthanas: Shuddha Rishabham, Antara Gandharam, Shuddha Madhyamam, Shuddha Daivatam and Kakali Nishadam. Now let us change the Re and Da. And we will learn how to sing or play Re 2, that is Chatushruti Rishabham, and Da 2, Chatushruti Daivatam. Rest all will be same. This becomes the ragam Shankarabharanam. So Shuddha Rishabham, dull. Re. So some activeness is there. So if a person is sleeping and suddenly if you wake him up, he'll be telling ah. So that is nothing but that activeness will come. That is Re 2. Sleeping person is Re 1. Active person is Re 2. Okay? Re. Yes, I am awake. I am present. Re. I am still sleeping. Yes, I am awake. If you give gamakam to Ree. Ree. Yes, I am more active. So, giving gamakam to a swaram makes it more active. Now, I guess you will be able to differentiate between Ree 1 and Ree 2. Ree 1, dull. Ree 2, active. So, we are done with both the rishabams. Ga is same. Antaragandharam. Ma is same. Shuddhamadhyamam. Pa is same. Now let us go to Daivatam. Sleeping Da. That is Davan. Pa Da. I am still sleeping. Pa Da. Yes, I am awake. Da is Da too. If you give Gamakam. Pa Da. Yes, I am more active. So I guess you got the difference between both the Rees and both the Das. So Ni is common. Kakal Nishadam. Sa. Now you got to know Ree 1, Ree 2, Ga 2, Ma 1, Pa, Da 1, Da 2 and Ni 2. What else swaras are left over? You have to know how to sing Ga 1, Ma 2, Ni 1. Now let us consider a ragam. Shanmukhapriya. So we'll be having Ree 2. In this ragam, as I have told you, we'll be getting Ga 1, Sadharana Gandharam. Ga. Ga is also very dull. Antar Gandharam I have sung boldly. But Sadharana Gandharam is dull enough. Sare Ga. This Sadharana Gandharam. Now we'll be going to Ma 2, Prati Madhyamam. Ma 1 is Ma, bold, straight line. Ma Pratimadhyamam, that is curved. Ma 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 Shuddhamadhyamam. Ma is Pratimadhyamam. So Shuddhamadhyamam is a straight line, Pratimadhyamam is a curve. So Sarega Ma Ma, almost equivalent to Pa. Pa Ma Ma Ma. When you sing Ma, it is heard as Pa Ma only. Ma. Da is sleeping. So this is Da 1. Sa Re Ga. Ga is sleeping. Ma wave. Pa Da. Da is sleeping. Ni Sa Ni. It is not equivalent to Sa. So what is this? This is Ni 1. Ni. So Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Da. You got to know about Ree 1, Ree 2, the difference. So if you compare the ragam Shankarabharanam and Maya Malavagola, so you will be getting a difference between Ree 1, Ree 2, Da 1, Da 2, etc. When you add a ragam Shanmukhapriya, you will be getting difference between Ma 1 and Ma 2. Now I will compare Shankarabharanam and Shanmukhapriya. Sarigama is Shankarabharanam. Ga is Antargandharam. Is also dull. Ma is also flowing like it is curved. So that is Shanmukhapriya starting. Sa Re Ga Ma. This is Shanmukhapriya. This is Shankarabharanam. So in each and every swarasthanam there is a magic hidden behind it. So now I guess you have understood what is the nature of each and every swarasthanam and how to identify a swarasthanam. Now beyond all this, let us consider a ragam Kapi. In Kapi, except Ma 2 and Ree 1, we will be getting almost all the swaras, like as Anya swaras also. Ni Sa Ga, Sadhana Gandharam. Ni Sa Ga, Antara Gandharam. So, in small variation, that is Ga 1 and Ga 2, that brightness changes. So, that makes the difference. Even Ma Pa Ni Pa is Ni 1. Pa Ni Sa is Ni 2. So when you play Arohanam, you will be getting Kakali Nishadam in Kapi. When you come Avarohanam, Kaisaki Nishadam will be there. That is Ni Sa Kakali Nishadam. So other than these, we'll be getting Antara Gandharam and Shuddha Daivatam also. So basically, there are three Anyaswaras in the Ragam Kapi. I hope you all understood the difference between the Swarasthanas. Comment me in the comment section if you are having any doubts. Thank you so much.